This is a 1987 Honda CB500. They were imported at that time, at the same time when they put their four-cylinder Hondas out. So the market was pretty reluctant to purchase these. So they exported them, really exported them to America and the UK and New Zealand. And that's where I got this from. They're a pretty rare bird, but they're a bit of a cult machine too. Very nice to ride. Got electric start with a kicker. So there you go.
Yeah, Rob Holloway, couple of my sunny day down here with the club. I've got a 1984 Yamaha XT600. Yamaha XT500 is where it's all started, and it progressed through. It's been going for a long time now. They won a couple of Paris to Dakar races. That's what made them most popular. Though this is at a Tenere, this is just a proper XT road trail bike. But it's a good old girl, ticks along, enjoys itself. So that's about it, really. Thank you.
Good morning, my name is Ross King, been a member for a number of years but not very active, but lovely to see a little bit of sun this morning. What I've got here is a Kawasaki A1SS from 1967, this model. They weren't very popular here in Australia. This one I bought in from the United States, found it in a barn, which was great, up in the back hills behind San Diego about 6 or 7 years ago. Bought it back with a few other motorcycles which I've since restored. So this one, being a 250cc, a little bit different, two-stroke, but with rotary disc valve. So under those circumstances, the induction is by the end of each crankshaft, by a disc, which has a slot in it, and that controls the input of the fuel when it's needed. So consequently, we don't have any carburetors on display. They're in the covers on the side of the motor. And that makes it a little bit unusual. It's got an unusual tone to it, a bit like a rotary, I suppose. It's a great little bike, good fun, and just something else to have in amongst a collection of half a dozen that I've got.
Hi, my name's Ian Thomas. I'm a guest here at the Pitwater Motor Enthusiast today, courtesy of Louis Bedell. So I've brought my 2003 anniversary Harley Davidson Ultra Classic Electroglide along. I want to have a bit of a squiz at it. This one's not a showpiece. This is a working bike. I've ridden a lot around Australia, and I used it as a commuter bike for a long time. So it's got a few dints and scrapes on it, but I love every one of them because it's just the best bike. It's the third I've had of these. I had a 1997, I had a 2002, and I left that in the United States in a heap, I'm sorry to say. But this is a really good one. This is a classic motorcycle. Anniversary, 100 years of Harley Davidson.
Donald, and this is my 2007 Buell XB12X. So it's the soft-roader version. There weren't many of those made. Eric Buell in himself was a motorcycle designer for Harley Davidson. He had an ambition to build racing bikes, so he left Harley Davidson and set up his own bike company called Eric Buell Racing, EBR, and designed a lot of racing bikes in the States. The reason I bought it is because of his unique design features, of which there are many on this bike. We'll maybe show you around them, but if you start at the front, he's got a disc brake that actually follows the actual circumference of the front wheel, so it gives incredible braking force. He was trying to keep the weight as low as possible. So whilst it's got a 1200 Harley engine in it, Sportster engine, the frame wraps around that. And instead of having a fuel tank up high, the fuel's held in the frame. Added to that, the oil tank is in the rear swing arm, so that removes the need for an oil tank elsewhere on the bike, and the exhaust pipe is slung underneath the bike to keep it low. Even though it's a soft roader, so it rides fairly high, this one. I bought it because, well, it was unique, plus I wanted to ride across Australia, and the upright position, riding position, was something I think I needed after, well, doing 10 days, 800 k's a day across this beautiful country. So that's how it ended up with me. Final feature is the little flip-up dicky seat for my wife, and she occasionally gets on the back with me, but that gives her a feeling of extra security. So I love the bike, done and seen a lot of this beautiful country riding it, and I hope to have it for many years to come. Thank you.
Bikes, yeah!
Fantastic. Okay.